You have no idea.
Recognize one.
Gray head. Adelphia?
This is my wife, Marla.
Hi, nice sorry to catch your name.
Paul's not George's name, but I don't know my George anymore.
Billy, can I go by Paul? I didn't recognize you when I saw you.
George, come on here and sit with me.
Where are you going?
Betty.
I'm know that.
This is where you used to come and go out the door, you know, outside. So the dressing rooms over here, they tore the dressing rooms off and built all the new wings. You go in, go down those steps, and come back out this door and go back to the new wing if you want to.
Sliding down. Did we ever slide down there?
Stand off to your right, Joe. Right. Just go.
Y'all don't they remember?
Let me know what I'm doing.
Library used to be?
No, the door was
See, this is the outside wall. This is a 30-inch thick wall right here in the sign. You know, you see the
she's already married to somebody else. That's what I heard about him 2 months ago.
That's a pretty expensive area, though.
Yeah,
do you have your kids on there?
One was on the
wire.
Yeah.
Oh, I swear that's just a building.
Well, I guess
this was a story.
I know. I hate them. Do you have any idea? I wish I had this.
Thank you. Received a letter from a 1969 graduate who is vacationing in Hawaii. Right now, I'd like to read parts of it to you. Friday, I visited four of my old teachers in the rest home, Hawaiian Paradise. The home is luxurious and quite expensive, but these teachers could afford the outrageous fees because they became so wealthy while teaching in CHS. And if you went around the school today, I'm sure you could see why. As I approached room 101, I saw Mr. Teague typing a letter to his son. By the time he hunted up each key and pecked it with his index finger, he had forgotten the word and had to check his copy. Since he couldn't even remember me, I proceeded to the gym area. where Mrs. Ann Mays was leading isometrics from a wheelchair. So as not to interrupt her efforts, I proceeded to the pool where I saw, probably, Mrs. Gus Lehman sunning on her surfboard. That's a sight to behold. I recognized her when she removed her sunglasses and walked over to greet her. It was very difficult to talk to her because she wore out her vocal cords back in CHS, probably hauling at Robbins. That was mine. And now she must write everything she wants to say. After a short visit, I went to see Mr. Marshall Stovall, who is living in Abilene, for those of you that didn't know that. He was sitting in his red rocking chair reading newspapers. He's still a rather unusual man, and these newspapers are part of his plays. Hobby, thank you. He collects them. He pulled out papers from the last 20 years, and many of them were filled with articles about members of my graduating class. I am enclosing some of them, which I hope you will enjoy reading. Flash, Mewburn graduates. President of the U.S., Mike Luckowitz, has presented Glenn Mewburn with the Congressional Medal of Honor in the luxurious nightclub belonging to Gerald Newcomb. Mewburn will finally be able to serve in the Army after having received a student deferment from the draft for 10 consecutive years in order to be able to finish high school. Did you want to read all of these or just a portion of them? It's several pages. And everybody in the graduating class was listed. I don't think I have, but I couldn't read it that fast. Sports. I like this one. Now in the sports section, we have a focus on an athlete. Art Wagner, after hitting a double in the first game with Alpine, is sure that he will be offered a baseball scholarship from Texas A&M. Dexter Took, after the sacrifice of his tooth, has finally learned to ride a skateboard successfully. Beverly Rucker and Janice Summer both jailed Thursday night for celebrating New Year's Day in the middle of May on Main Street. Jackie Jeffrey is now starring in his newest Broadway hit, Whatever Happened to Daisy Lane? Rexanne Shelton gave a concert Sunday afternoon, and her main piece, Chopsticks, was greatly enjoyed. Other pieces played were Twinkle Twinkle Little Star, Three Blind Mice, and Peter Peter Pumpkin Eater. Denise Sales was treated and released from the emergency ward at the hospital after breaking her toe by tripping over a tennis ball. You always were graceful, weren't you, Denise? Gurley won't like that one. Dear Elian Wall, my class ring has been passed back and forth between my girlfriend and me so much that it is flat worn out, and I will have to get a new one. My question is, do you think she should help pay for the new ring? Ronnie Gurley. Gary McQuarrie, president of the National Pig Association, had his right arm nearly torn off by his prize sow, but the quick action of world-famous renowned woman Dr. Florence Glenda Hamilton Nightingale saved his life. Clayton Finch. Poor Clayton. He's not here tonight. He weighs 400 pounds, by the way. He's not here. Who the hell knows? Clayton Finch, who designed the famous peacock pants, has gained worldwide recognition on this design. Y'all don't remember those pants, do you? Danny Davis is the only person who has ever been bitten by a quail. During his stay in the hospital, he was greatly confused as to how a dead quail could give such a ferocious bite. Mary Nell Horn's lawyer team, Martha Ingram and Lois Hancock, is appealing to Judge Bobby Eder in hopes of breaking the suit, which was brought against her by Carnegie Hall for breaking a contract. In the medical world today, history was made when Stan Allen received the first transplant of human hair. Joe Smith, alias Charles Atlas II, now appears regularly with the Ringling Brothers Circus. He now weighs 100 pounds and 1 full ounce. Elaine Irvin broke her leg trying to keep up with Steve Pettit. But she... Does this go back or what? But she could... But she could just could not vault 13 feet. Oh, wow. Susan Tobin has recently received word that she will be accepted into a well-known singing group. The director, Janet McManus, feels that Susan will be a definite leader in the bass section. Jeez. Oh. Kerry Coleman and Vic Craig were jailed in Sonora Friday. Did you know that they were released only after giving back the deer meat? 3 years after Eddie Henderson graduated from UT, he told his secret for success. He said he never opened a book because they confused him, and above all, he never removed his glasses. Your turn, Robin. Two former Crane students, Randy Robbins and Sue Evans, were elected Students of the Year for 1973 at Texas A&M. Fire Chief James Borchfield reports that it took 100 firemen and a hook and ladder truck to extinguish a fire at the home of Keith Cessna. Borchfield was baffled at the cause of the fire, which started in the bedroom. By all rights, I should skip this one because it's mine. No, but I'm going to read it anyway. Y'all are going to get a kick out of this, I think. I did. Dear Abby, could you possibly tell me how many Susans live close to West Point in New York? The name Susan has always seemed to attract me. My wife's name's Jill. Ronnie Cooper broke his leg the other day while practicing for a rodeo. Fell off his Shetland pony. Here's one that goes back. Pat Kelly and Della Kirkendall were both admitted to the hospital on Thursday. After taking x-rays, the doctor found that they both had ulcers. When asked what they thought had brought on these ulcers, both girls admitted that they had been worrying about how to fix their hair. And for those of y'all that haven't seen the video that Bobby put together, you need to see that to really appreciate this one. Few people know that the once popular song Hair was really written by Crane's own Raymond Modisette. Danny Stevens, the owner of the Ford Motor Company and repair shop, states that his specialty is repairing cars with faulty brakes and those that are prone to drive into buildings. Dennis Young is opening Young's Barbershop. His first customer, on whom he will demonstrate his stylish burr, will be Stan Williamson. Paula Davidson's column, always has helpful pointers on how to raise 13, 14, or 15 children. She is not sure how many she has. You can count that high, can't you? And then finally down here, it says, as you can see, the 69 class did not fade into oblivion after all. They really made the news. It's no wonder that the old teachers of CHS got their enjoyment from looking up accomplishments, I can't even read, of their students. Thanks. Some of us have changed, some of us haven't. Henderson, I'm still not sure if that's really you or not. That's all right. We don't want to know. Now, it's really good to see all of you. And again, I'd like to add my thanks to Randy's and those that you've expressed earlier, to Bill and Paula and Betty and Bobby, for all the hard work that they've done. It hasn't been easy, and we do appreciate it And for those of you that want to come to New Orleans, where we live now, you need to get your reservations in early. We have some friends in Washington that have already started booking up. So it's, yeah, for Mardi Gras, it's a good time. So thank you, and it's good to see all of you.
I like to think that life is full of little ironies, like probably the most unorganized and flakiest guy in our class is running the show. He's right over there talking to Bobby Tillman. But all seriousness aside, I don't want you people to feel too old, because I don't. And the reason is, I'm younger than all you people. Remember that? Yeah. Call me Junior. Okay, y'all wanna hear a little bit of Each Wheel here? Here we go. Here's a good one. In relinquishing, Elaine, I'm talking. I have the floor. In relinquishing such said title, we do hereby enact the following. We, Pam Smith, Amanda Esquivel, Debbie McFarland, Carolyn McKinney, Sally Marshall, and Billie Jean Taylor, leave our ability to get along with Mr. O'Dowdy and our artistic talent to George Simon. We also will to Delphia Carter our ability and willpower never to complain. What does that mean, Delphia? Where are you? I, Peppy Pop, will to Ronnie Willis a pickle and some peanuts. A pickle and some peanuts. I don't know what that means either. We, Sherry Weatherby, Patty Webb, and Toby Grissom, leave to Susan Tobin, Paula Davidson, and Marinelle Horn our ability to burn McCamey's bonfire in broad daylight without getting caught by the McCamey Badgers. Was that Elaine? You have something?
No, I got one for that.
Y'all might appreciate this. I don't think Karen's here, but this is good. We, Sandy McKinney, Connie Batson, Mary Barandi, Vicki Dillard, Gloria Hubbard, and Jeannie Wade, will to Karen Robertson our strong willpower in remaining single our senior year. I think she did that, didn't she? Didn't she just make it? George. I, John Paul Lawless, most wholeheartedly will my ultra-bright toothpaste to Susan Townsend in hopes that it gives her smile sex appeal. I, Sybil Bargsley, will to Paula Davidson and Beverly Rucker my ability to sing and act. I, Clarence Neal, being of very sound mind and of some sound body, leave to Jackie Jeffrey and Tommy Jones my very deepest sympathy if they make it to the senior class and my talented versatility with schoolgirls. Okay, I'll try this one. We, the senior girls of CHS, most graciously leave to Coach Calvin Kirkham our names and phone numbers. Most of us will be available during the summer months. I'm not going to say it. I, Biff Pope, leave to Bill Cass and Rodney Quisenberry my ability to tell a good joke in hopes that they may someday get a laugh. Salvador Primera will to Don Carter my outstanding ability to fix cars. Can you do that, Don? I, Kenny Carl Smith, will to Kerry Coleman my great shaving skill in hopes that he always gets as smooth a shave as I did. I, Toby Grissom, will Jeannie Caraway any leftover gum or wintergreens that I may have left. Left where, I don't know. I, John Farmer, leave my ability to square things with Beverly Weatherby to Jimmy Burr. Ooh, 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 ooh. We, D. Johnson and Groovy, will to Ronnie Cooper our great ability to get along with our former employer, Elmo Bristow. I just read them, folks. I don't understand them. I, Royal Duncan, leave my outstanding grades in Mr. Stovall's government and economics class, plus all my broken bones and bruises, to Ronnie Willis. I, Lynn Barton, will to Dennis Young my great ability to get along with Coach Andreg on the football field. He's not here, so we'll pick on this guy. I, Danny Alvey, will to Keith Cessna my ability to get along with Phyllis Hickey and also my ability to scare big babies. I, Deborah Harless, leave my position as Noon Lions Club sweetheart to Sue Evans. And to Debbie Darden, I will my unbelievable ability never, never to stick my foot in my mouth. I wish somebody would have willed me that a few years ago. I, Jane Bell, will Janice Salmon my three little green men. Do y'all want to go to ours, or do you want to hear the rest of this one? I'm flexible. Had enough. This is the last will and testament of the senior class of 1969. We, the seniors of 69, in order to form a more perfect student body, to divert confusion, to ensure scholastic tranquility, provide the riddance of 84 certain common offenses, to promote utter chaos, and to...
It's happening!
And to secure the blessings of intellectual liberty, that is, complete idleness of mind, to ourselves and our posterity, do henceforth make public in memory of the seniors of 69 this our last will and testament. I, Randy Robbins, will to L.V. Tennyson my house at 1111 South Catherine so he will not have so far to drive in order to see Diane. And to LaVita Kroger the ability not to smile. I, Keith Cessna, will to Robert Bezak my Playboy magazine in hopes that he will finally find out something he can't learn in school. I, Joe Smith, will to Tommy Parker the extra height that Mike Pearl willed to me last year to be used in a way he wants to use it. And what is that? preferably to be taller than Debbie Darden. I, Richard Pearson, will to Billy Box my ability to chew tobacco in class and to drive in the dark. Charlie Hamilton, you remember driving in the dark? You were good at it, babe. I, Sue Evans, will to Joanne Hubbard a year's supply of red light bulbs. Will be a few extra bulbs for her to will next year to her running mate, Miss Doris Sue Dameron. I, Loretta Foster, will to Pam Hayes my sex appeal, and to Jackie Kaiser my ability to pass government and economics. I, Susan Tobin, will to Ellen Duckwitz 105 large Cokes, 283 packages of barbecue potato chips, 351 burritos, 542 orders of French fries, 406 packages of green gum, all from the Dairy Mart. Good eating. I, Janice Salmon, will to Johnny Westmoreland the ability to try again if at first he doesn't succeed. I, Ronnie Cooper, will to Gerald Edwards my ability to ride bulls and to practice riding on Mr. Teague's steers without getting caught. I, Gary McQuarrie, will to Larry Wagner my ability to flatten Art Wagner. Now, there's a practical solution there. I, Marinelle Horn, will to the typing 2 students my district winning typing speed. What was your speed? Where's Marinelle? 80 words a minute. I, Jim Gnarl Hester, will to Billy Earl Box the ability to look after Carla Sue Mars and 29 empty boxes of Copenhagen. Stuff comes back to haunt you, Jim. Davidson will to Jackie Hansen the ability to double expose the Big Lake football negatives with the pictures of the ladies eating breakfast. It looked like it. I, Jackie Box, will to Tommy Parker, Ben Scott, Steve Cranford, and any other juniors all of my old tennis rackets to use as defense against all of the underclass bullies. We, Billy Owen and Stan Allen, will to Rita Seaborn a ticket to the television show To Tell the Truth. We'll say that one. I, Leslie Manzel, will to Joanne Hubbard my pink and white striped dress. And to Ricky Lehman, Don Townsend, Steve Sawyer, and Jackie Hansen my ability to dodge footballs, basketballs, volleyballs, tennis balls, crossbars, golf balls, baseballs, and dirty looks. I, Janet McManus, will to Kay Daniel my ability not to hold my nose so high in the air. I, Clayton Finch, will to the sponsors of the junior and senior classes earplugs to be worn during the prom. Wasn't that music just terrible? Just terrible. We, I don't know what this means. We, Ed Henderson and Charlie Hamilton, will to Johnny Johnson a new psychedelic painted iron lung so that he may breathe easier in his last days. Yeah. We, Renee Allen, Melissa Clement, Janice Salmon, Diana Williams, Martha Ingram, Della Kirkendall, and Betty Coffey, will to Tony Jones the ability to fight back or switch. Table number four. We, Jackie Box and Paula Davidson, will to Robert Bezak and Penny Pettit our ability to get the rest of the student council interested and concerned in all our projects. Futile. And an 8.5 month supply of super duper energy producer to take when the other council members' interest and concern fails to continue after the first 2 weeks of school. We, Ronnie Gurley and Randy Robbins, will to Debbie Mathis and to Linda Brazil, one carton of toilet paper, a dozen rolls of masking tape, so they will be prepared for the 1969 and 70 basketball season. Like this one. We, Diana Williams, Rexanne Shelton, Susan Tobin, Susan Townsend, and Paula Davidson, will to Carla Mars, Debbie Mathis, Joanne Hubbard, Diane Robinson, and Melanie Cole, all our skirts, which are only 2 inches above the knee. Oh. We, Melissa Clement and Renee Allen, will to Bobby Scott and Guy Birdwell, the thought to remember us at all times. And forever. I, Danny Davis, will to the Pep Squad's junior members, the effigy of a fellow Crane Golden Crane, George, that I recovered from McCamey during the 67 football game, carry him to all the games for good luck. Is she here? Will to Yolanda Jeffrey and Etta Morris my ability to get along with not just boys, but everyone. I, Carrie Bob Coleman, will to Billy Burton the ability to watch out for quarterback sneaks. I, Denise Sales, leave to Janice Palmer my long blonde hair so she can have more fun. And to Donna and Vanna, my favorite dance routine in twirling, so that they will have more fun. We, Elaine Irvin and Denise Sales, would like to will to next year's twirling victims our two scratched batons, two twirling suits, if they are not too large. Read them like I see them, folks. Two pairs of twirling boots and our ability to get along with each other as well as the other twirlers. We think they'll need it. We, Cecile Hogan, Karen Robertson, Leslie Manziel, Pat Price, and Marianne Salmon, will to Diane Robinson, Carla Mars, Melanie Cole, and Kay Daniel, our engagements. I, Danny Stevens, will to Randy Morrison, my ability to play the tuba and stay out of trouble in the tuba section. Those boys get in lots of trouble in that tuba section.
Beer. No.
I, Karen Robertson, I wish she was here. Will to Diane Robinson, my ability to find one boy and stick with him. We, Betty Coffey and Lois Hancock, will to Marilyn Horak, the luck to be in it instead of out of it. And also our ability to be good conversationalists. Yes. We, Jackie Box and Denise Sales, will to L.V. Tennyson and Diane Robinson, our amazing ability to never quarrel and to never get caught saying a passionate goodbye by a certain P.E. teacher. I, Bill Cass, will to L.V. Tennyson my outstanding athletic ability in order that he may attain higher goals in his future athletic endeavors. I, Dexter Took, will to Melanie Cole my ability to keep my false tooth in. I, Betty Coffey, will to Rita Seaburn my ability to get along on band trips, and to Pam Hayes the ability to type without looking at the keyboard. I, Ronnie Willis, will to Ben Scott my worn out place on the bench, my duty as headphone operator, and a pair of tweezers. I got rid of the big splinters but left the little ones, which can cause a lot of pain, for you. I, George Simon, will to Sarita Harvey my great ability to get along with Mike Batson, and also my great dramatic ability. You were always a modest little devil, George. I, Glenn Mewburn, will to Robert Bezak my ability to maintain a high grade average during my high school years. I, Susan Townsend, will to Danny Smith my ability to tell the difference between a rabbit and a cow in hopes that he will not have to pay for another cow like the one he killed on his last hunting trip. We, the English 4 classes, will to next year's English 4 classes the ability to stay awake during lectures. Mary Nell, do you remember? Where are you? That's right. We, the physics class of 69, all 8 of us, will to Mr. Zachary hair, grotesque Aggie jokes, our moronic ability to misinterpret the instructions, and all the torn up equipment and gas outlets. Remember that, Mr. Wallace? We, the senior members of the 6-period crafts class, will to next year's crafts class is the ability to live through Mr. Eggleston's country sayings such as, I buy you books and I buy you books and all you do is tear the corners off, you Han Yachts. and the ability to live through 26 verses of How Much Is That Doggy in the Window and still be able to say, it's free. I, Steve Pettit, will to Benny Wilson my place in the pole vaulting competition at regional. Maybe the fourth time's a charm. We, Glenda Hamilton and Martha Ingram, will to Donna Parker our ability to get along with Mr. Teague. I could have used that. I, Tommy Jones, will to next year's football and basketball teams a lot of luck and hope they may go all the way to state. Fat chance. I, James Bortsfield, will to Robert Bezak my ability to place last in district UIL number sense, along with my slide rule in hopes that he can use it. I, Sammy Lane, will to Yolanda Jeffrey the ability to get along, get along, get along. I, Paula Davidson, will to Ricky Lehman my ability to keep junior annual staffers at work when Mrs. Stroder is gone, my ability to meet all deadlines a day late, the key to the picture file, and my best wishes for a wonderful 1970 LIV. I, Jackie Mighty Jeffrey, will to Yolanda, Etta, Argy, and Daisy my superior ability to pass economics. I, Pat Kelly, will to Debbie Mathis my good manners. We, Karen Robertson, Janet McManus, George Simon, Cecile Hogan, Dorothy Turner, Jerry Langston, will to Jill Rogers, Vonna Parker, R.G. Hollins, Linda Thackeray, Annette Lopez, and all other next year's journalists our ability to have surprise parties without Mrs. Stroder knowing, our ability to leave school to get food, and our ability to write good short stories. We, the seniors of 1969, will to next year's senior class the ability to establish a senior day in hopes that Mr. Ford will find the kindness and understanding in his heart to let them use it after 11 and three-quarters years of waiting. That's it. And I would like to say I've enjoyed this, and I appreciate you people being yourselves and coming here with the main purpose of meeting each other, seeing each other again, and talking about old times. It's been a real kick for me.
Thanks, Ed. That's a good job. One thing that I failed to notice, and I feel bad about this, we do have a member of our class who is deceased, and that is Bobby Adair. So I was just made aware of that. I wanted to mention earlier, I did not. Okay. We would like to recognize the members of our class who served in the United States Armed Forces. So would you guys stand up and let us just say, way to go. Don Carter, Danny Davis, Billy Owens, and Ron Willis, 1 year at West Point. Go, guys. I hope you don't take this next category here unpatriotically and take it with the humor that it's intended. We also have some quasi-military people that served. Elaine Urban, Girl Scouts. Eddie Henderson served with Dowell. Randall Robbins, longest 4F classification, McCamey, Office of the United States Draft Board. Boy, that was good. Okay. Least change, boy. / man. George Simon. Okay, Delphia, you got the least changed girl. The couple that's married the longest, one time, same mate. Is that is right, not cumulative years for marriages. Sorry, Box, we can't work that deal in. Pat Price Hollins. Couple with the most human children. Jackie and Daisy Jeffrey. Six on the ground. None on the way, is that right? Six on the ground, none on the way. No. Graduate with the youngest child, which probably has something to do with failing home ec class, or maybe the technique was a long time in explanation. I don't. Danny Davis, 5 months. We gotta count them on the ground. Our last award is the member of the class 1969 that came the furthest to get here. And I think this is fantastic. Rexanne Shelton, 1,050 miles. Rexanne. Have I left anything out? Do we have any more announcements?
And all the flowers. Joyful blossoms in gloomy earth, all can never grow.
Love that springs from deceitful hearts
can with grief bestow. Yet a life full of hope and truth blossoms eternal flourish. Hear you not how spirits of their spirits of each whisper. Hear you not how spirits of their beauty softly whisper.
Oh! Two guesses who this is.
May not have the big belly, but I certainly have the bald head.
I sure am sorry that I'm not going to be able to be there to be a part of the class reunion this year. I would have given anything to be able to be there to see all of you again. But I'm here in Okinawa now. See, the military has me here overseas, and I'm sort of stuck.
Well, here's the Purdue family. This picture was taken about a year ago in Lemoore, California. About 2 years ago now in California. There's my oldest son, Chris, in the middle, who was born back in 74. And to his left, on the right side, is my second son, Stephen. Chris now, my first boy, has just finished his freshman year in high school in San Clemente. And Stephen has just finished his seventh grade year in San Clemente Junior High. Now, the other two little kids, Sarah, my girl, my sweet girl, is 9 years old, and she's finishing up the third grade now. And Jonathan is my youngest. He's now finishing up the first grade. So there's the family of four, and of course, there's my wife, Susan, down in the front. God has really blessed us with a wonderful family. I have many things to be thankful for. They're all in good health. They're all doing well in school. And they're all making their daddy real proud and real happy for them.
This is a letter received from Ronnie Warren. It says, Dear Paula, received your forwarded letter this past weekend. Was very thoughtful of you to include me in the reunion plans. Sorry to have to decline due to prior commitments. I would really have enjoyed visiting with some of those really old classmates. Please let me know addresses and so forth so that I might get in touch. Enclosed is a picture of my family. It has been 1966 on a visit back to Crane since I was there, but I did marry a West Texas girl. Information requested is below. Thanks once again. God bless. Ronnie. This is a letter received from Beverly, and her name is Beverly Rucker Goats. It says, Dear Bobby, it was good talking with you today. I'm sorry I couldn't make it to the reunion. It sounds like I missed a lot. I think a 25-year reunion in the Dallas area sounds great. This is the most recent picture of myself. Sorry it is black and white. I took this picture of my daughter this summer. Hope this helps. Love, Beverly. This is a letter received from Lois Hancock. It says, Dear Paula, so I thought I'd drop you a line or two to explain why I can't make the 20-year reunion. I'm an LVN, and I've been going to college for 1.5 years, working toward a Bachelor of Social Worker degree. I've made the Be Honor Rolls each semester. I have to study hard, but I like it. I'm working this first summer session in Dublin at the nursing home, and I can't get off because I'm working for people who are taking their vacations. I've waited hoping I could get off, but I can't. I'm sending some pictures, and maybe they can be used in the video. Sure wish I could make it. I'd love to see y'all and the rest of the people in our class. One of my girls is getting married. One of my girls got married last May, and she's expecting her first baby the last of July or first of August. I'll be a grandma at 38. She's Donna Lynn, age 19. The other girl was married last month. She's 18 years old. Her name's Paula Sue. Samuel will be going into the ninth grade next year. Please keep in touch with me. Thank you. Love, Lois. I wanted to introduce my children. They were at the barbecue and the banquet and just about all of the other events and helped quite a bit in some of the stuff going on there. But it didn't seem like we ever had enough time to tie them down and get them in a picture. But at any rate, this is Cheryl and Krista. They're Betty and my twins. They're 17 years old now, seniors at Garland High School. This is my son, Brian. He's 14, and he's a freshman at Garland High School. And ironically, they go to school with Marinelle Horn, who is now Marinelle Turnage, and Mike Turnage's two boys. They are real good kids. They're doing well in school. They're very athletic, which their father was not, as you well know, but we're very proud of them. The next picture here is my mom and dad. Most of you know them, I think. My mom taught some of you in the third grade. She taught there in the Crane school system for about 30 years. She taught 33 altogether. My father taught in Odessa for 8 years and then came to Crane and taught, I believe, 16 years there, but most of us had already passed through elementary by that time. Real proud of my kids, my wife Betty, and my family. Just wanted to let you see them. Thank you very much.
Wessonberry, this is my wife Marjorie, and this is Jamie, she's age 10, and Sarah, she's age 5. We live in Odessa. I work for Phillips Pipeline Company. My wife is a teacher. We've been in Odessa since 75.
Hello, I'm Eddie Henderson. My wife is Kella, my son Cody, and my daughter Chaley Jo.
Where are you from?
We're from Odessa, Texas. I work for Phillips Petroleum, trying to make a living in the oil patch and raising these kids so they'll turn out hopefully better than I did.
I'm Susan Townsend Loyalist. These are my sons John and Paul and Yancey. I'm a third grade teacher in Crane. I'm married to John Paul Loyalist, and we've lived in Crane for 6 years now.
Hi, I'm Bob Downs, and this is my wife Jeannie Caraway Downs. This is my son over there to the left, Brian, and to his immediate right is Cynthia, and this is Christy. We live up in Grafton, Virginia, which is north of Virginia Beach, Norfolk area. I'm stationed there with the Air Force, and we've been there for about a year. And Jeannie was the one that graduated high school here. I went to school in Roscoe, so I'm somewhere about the local area. And that's really about it.
Hi, I'm Danny Young. Live in Fort Stockton now. And any of y'all that want to play golf with me sometime, come on down. I'd love to see you.
Hi, I'm Mike Cogburn, and this is my wife, Pat Kelly Cogburn. You remember Pat from 69, I guess? She was only in high school a couple years in Crane, I think, but these are our two daughters we have with us. This is Kristen, she's 8, and this is Lindsay, and she's 20 months old. And we have a son that's 12 years old, and he's not with us today. He's had to go to a scout camp up in Athens, Texas. And I don't think Lindsay's going to stay with us very long. We live in the city of Coppell, which is a suburb of Dallas, up near DFW Airport. I'm an architect, and Pat graduated from TWU in nursing. You want to say anything?
No. Except I was glad to be here. It's good to see everybody.
Okay, thanks.
Hi, my name is Randall Robbins, or you used to call me Randy Robbins. And this is my beautiful wife, Glenna, from Turkey, Texas, whose colors were also purple and gold. I just wanted you to meet Miss Turkey High School, 1968. And this is Joyce, my oldest daughter, and this is Coy. We live in Capitan, New Mexico. We are ex-farmers who've been forced off our land, and now we're living as recluses up in the high country of the Sacramento Mountains. We'd just like to make this statement. For all of y'all who bought this tape, we have a schedule we'd like for you to sign up. We'd like for everybody to call Jackie Box a different day at 2:30 in the morning for the next 2 years. We love you guys and hope we get to see you next year.
My name is Roy Carlson, and this is my family. This is my wife, Jancy Renee Allen Carlson. And this is my daughter, Melissa Ann Carlson. And this is Brett Carlson. We're from Burleson, Texas. I'm a used car dealer in Fort Worth, and my wife is a part-time nurse and housewife. You want to say something?
All I want to say is to the class of 69 is that I love you all very much.
I'm Jack Atkinson. If you were here in the 8th grade, I was your science teacher since I was the only one. And I still live here in Crane. My wife and I are both retired, and I substitute in the high school and middle school here now. And wherever you are, if I paddled the boys, why, you know, probably you needed it. But just forget about it, okay?
Hi, I'm Bob Chisholm. This is my wife, Susan Tobin Chisholm. This is our daughter, Brittany, and we're from Spring, Texas, and we're home builders.
Just wanted to say that it's lovely to be here for our 20-year reunion. We hope we're at the 40th reunion, and thank you, Bobby, and your crew for putting all of this together. It's been a lovely time. Bye-bye.
Hello, I'm Danny Stevens, and this is my wife, Mary, my son, Daniel. I'm living now in Odessa, work for a white truck sales. I'm a mechanic. We'll see you next time. I had a real nice time this time. Thank you.
Hi, I'm Larry Smith. This is my wife, Marta Ingram Smith, and our daughter, Mandy. I'm working in off-field sales. My wife works for Phillips. We're glad to see y'all again.
My name is M.D. Ford. I was the principal of this class for roughly 6 years. Stayed in the Crane school system from 1955 to 1982. I have retired in 82. Play golf 5 days a week. Work in the Crane County Water District, American Cancer Society. And above all, I want the kids to remember me as Mr. Stoneface, because I never did smile at them while they were there. Thank you.
I'm Stan Allen. I want to introduce my family here. Rita's not with us this evening, but down the far left is my oldest daughter, Monica. And in the middle here is Megan. And my son, Monty. We live here in Crane. I work for National Oil Well and run the pro shop at the country club. Just like to say that Monica graduated this year, the class of 89, be attending, hopefully, Soil Ross on a scholarship. Monty will be a sophomore, and Megan's going to be an eighth grader. And we're tickled to death to see all y'all or to be talking to you or you listening to us to let you know that when you come to Crane, give us a holler, and we love you.
My name is Gary McQuarrie. I'd like to introduce to you my best friend on this earth. This is my wife and helpmate, Marcia, of 12 years, and who am I well pleased. This is my daughter, Stephanie. She's 6 years old, going to be 7 in September. This is Andrew. He's 9 years old, going to be 10 in October. We live in Crane right now. I work for ARCO here in Crane. I'm the fire marshal for the city and county of Crane.
Hi, my name is Jim Bortsfield. This is my wife, Pam. This is Jimmy and Dustin. We live in Dallas, Texas. Pam's a registered nurse, and I sell spas and hot tubs and gas grills and decks. Come see us sometime.
I'm Larry Fountain, and this is my family. This is Jan McManus Fountain. Little girl is Ashley, and we have an 18-year-old daughter named Christy who couldn't be here today. We're living in Hobbs, New Mexico, and we have an architectural business there.
My name's Dexter Took. This is my wife, Johnny Lou Smith Took. She's the sister of Joe Smith of our class, and this is my mom, Mrs. Took. Johnny and I live in Del Rio, out by Lake Amistad. I work at the hospital there in Del Rio. Johnny works for the school district.
I'm Evelyn Stroder, and this is my husband, Charles Stroder. And I taught English and journalism and sponsored the newspaper and the yearbook. Highlight of the year, your senior year, when I taught was the basketball game between the yearbook yokels and the Newsy Netters. And Tommy Jones was the referee in that. And that reminds me that another big highlight of that year was that trip to the state basketball tournament.
I'm Charles Stroder. I taught math and science. We're both retired now. We're both living. We still live in Crane.
I'm George Paul Simon, and I live in Arlington, Texas. I work for Bell Helicopter. I graduated from Crane High in 69. And this is my mother, Patricia Pendleton Simon, and she graduated from Crane High in 1943. And we think this is just great.
Hi, I'm Rexanne Shelton Herrick, and this is my kids, Jennifer and Jeffrey, and my parents, Mr. and Mrs. Shelton. We live in Montgomery, Alabama now, and my husband, Dennis, is there.
I'm Jim Hester, and this is my family. I did graduate in 1969 here at Crane High School. Believe it or not, I'm pastor of the Christian church here for the last 16 years. I knew you wouldn't believe it. Let me introduce my family. Most of you remember Carla. My oldest boy is Jamie. He'll be a sophomore in high school, Crane High School, next year. This is Matt. Matt will be a freshman at Crane High School this next year. And this is Hannah Beth, and she's going to be in the 7th grade, Crane Middle School. I'd just like to say it's nice to see all of you. Some of you are fatter than I expected, some grayer than I expected, but then so am I. Nice seeing you.
Okay, Rita, you can stop griping. I did forget Rita a while ago. Rita is at home taking care of the business, and she is looking fit to kill and still great as ever, and I still love you, and I didn't forget you. I just wanted to see if I could make you mad. See you later.
Hello, I'm Stan Williamson. This is my family, and we're all from Midland. This is my wife, Dee. My middle daughter, Susanna, my youngest daughter, four, which is Sarah, and this is Stan, Jr., 13, and we're living in Midland and came down here to have our 20th reunion, and we're having got a lot of fun, and I'm still watching this football film trying to figure out who missed that tackle on that punt return, Joe Barnes, because when we find out who it was that missed that tackle, we're going to kill him. All right, guys, that's all we've got to say. Nice being here. We'll see you in 10 more years, I guess.
Hello, I'm Paula Davidson Cass, and I live in Crane, Texas. And these are my girls, Gigi Denise, who's 9, and Nancy Beth, who's 4 years old. And my husband, Bill Cass, didn't come to the barbecue, and he's a rat fink for not coming. I teach here in Crane. I teach 2nd grade in Crane, and Bill works at school and is kind of like an assistant principal. He has a lot of administrative duties, and we've had a lot of fun planning this barbecue and get-together and hope everybody's enjoyed it.
Hi, I'm Diana Williams Dyer, and this is my family, and we all live in San Angelo, Texas. I'm a piano teacher right now, and my husband works for General Telephone in San Angelo, and I guess that's all.
Hi, I'm Dorothy Turner McLaughlin. I grew up in Crane, went all of my school years here. I'm married to Leslie McLaughlin, who also grew up in Crane. The pictures of our son, Tim, who's 14. We now live in Kilgore, Texas, in East Texas, and we've moved around quite a bit because Les is with Champion Chemicals, and he does get transferred.
Hello, I'm Ronnie Cooper. This is my wife, Tanita Earp Cooper, my daughter, Angela, and my son, Cody Bob. Tanita's graduate, 1972.
Yeah.
Thank you. We live 25 miles southwest of Crane in Crane County on a ranch. I'm in the ranching business, dirt contracting business, and sell oil field chemicals. My wife would like to say something now.
I didn't really want to say anything, Ronnie. We live on a ranch, and our children ride horses and rodeo on the side. They're involved in 4-H activities. Our daughter Angela is involved in 8th grade middle school sports, and Cody Bob will be in the 3rd grade. He will be 8 this month.
I'm Susan Tobin Chisholm, and this is my mother, Helen Tobin, and we wanted to say hello, and we're having a great time, and this is just super that we could all be together. Mother?
Hello. Well, it's wonderful seeing everyone. I knew everyone when they were little, and a lot of their parents when they were little, and it's a wonderful occasion, and I'm glad I could be here.
Hello, I'm Elaine Irvin. I live in Midland. I've got an oil and gas accounting service. I don't know what else.
That's it.
That's all I know.
My name is Betty Coffey. I live in Odessa. I have 3 children, Jennifer, 17, Angela, 12, and Andrew, 9.
Hello, everybody. I'm Olin Owen, alias Billy Owen. I'm in Marlow, Oklahoma, married, to Cricket, and she's not here today. She's 6 months pregnant. And anybody gets up Marlow way, come by and see me.
Hi, I'm Jim Burr. Lovita couldn't make it today. This is Lindsay, and this is Lauren, and I'm a CPA in Midland. I'm on tax practice. We've lived over it for the last 10 years. We'll see y'all later.
I'm Ethel Owens, and I was school nurse here for 33 years, and now I'm just enjoying myself and doing nothing.
I'm Helen Carroll. I taught second grade for 30 years. I still live in Crane, and I'm going to live here the longest day that I'm alive. Crane's the greatest place in the world to live.
I'm Cecile Hogan Miller. These are my daughters. Tracy's 19 and Sheldon's 16. And we live in Odessa. We have for the past 17 years. And I work for the fire department as a dispatcher.
All right. I'm Danny Davis. This is my lovely wife, Jeannie. We've been married about 5 years. We're living here in Odessa. At this 20th year reunion, out of 20 years, I've been in some kind of school for about 17. After 9 years of night school, I got a master's degree in geology, and I'm working as an industrial hygienist. And Jeannie and I have the distinction of receiving the award for the youngest child of 5 months. Thank you.
Hi, I'm Delphia Carter Ballard, and this is my daughter, Laura. Don't do this to me. And this is Tracy Ballard. And I am a LVN, and I work at a junior high in Longview, Texas, and I've been there for 6 years, and I enjoy it. And here's my twin brother.
My name is Don Carter. I live in Santiana. I'm married. I've got two kids. I've got a 13-year-old daughter and a 3-year-old son. And I'm a forklift driver. My wife is RN.
My name is Bill Abbott, and my wife, Betsy Carol Abbott. She was a Crane graduate. You want to say anything here?
No, tell me what you do.
I work for Texaco in Houston. And Betsy is a registered nurse who works for Ben Todd in the neuro intensive care unit. I've just been married for 4 years.
Hey, this is Ron Gurley. This is my wife, Debbie, my daughter, Leslie, and my son, Stephen. We live in North Richland Hills, which is part of Fort Worth. We've lived there since 1974. My wife and I both graduated from the University of Texas. We are both registered pharmacists. My daughter is 11 years old. She'll be in seventh grade. And Stephen is 7 years old and be in the second grade. They both attend Temple Christian School in Fort Worth. And we're having a blast, and we appreciate this opportunity to come and be with our old friends.
I'm graduated senior of 1969. This is my wife, Daisy Marie Lane Jeffrey. We have 4 kids of our own, 2 that we have adopted. I'm presently pastoring at Mount Zion Baptist Church in Crane and a Chevron lease operator. At this time, we've been married for 17 years. Our oldest son is 16. Our oldest son is 16, and our next is 14. Have 2 girls, one 13 and one 10 years old. And I really enjoyed myself, and Billy Owens and Barry's messing with me at the time. Thank you.
Hello, fellow classmates. I'm Gerald Newcomb, and I'm presently living in Odessa, Texas. At the moment, I'm still single, never been married, and at the moment, I'm between jobs, still looking.
Hi, I'm Mary Nell Turnage. This is my husband, Mike, and we have 2 boys. We live in Garland, Texas, and our first son was born in 1973, and our second one in 1975. We were married in 1970. And it's been the greatest honor tonight to get the most changed girl from the class of 1969. And I tell you, it's all due to this guy right here. He's really influenced me. Thanks.
From the University of Texas Health Science Center in Austin, I'm Dr. Red Duke.
Well, I'm Bill Cass.
Hello, I'm Paula Davidson Cass.
And I am not a Rat Fink, as my wife said earlier.
He's really not.
I finally showed up to this thing, and it's been a lot of fun. I really enjoyed it, and we've had a great time.
Don't you want to say anything? My wife is at a loss for words. Now, she is not one known to be at a loss for words. She talks constantly, sun up to sundown. But this time, she's going to let me talk. But I would just like to say a word to John Hood, if he gets a hold of this, to remember how we solved our chemistry problem in chemistry by drinking the solution. I wonder if you remember that, boy. And to all the other folks that we had a good time with, just remember the good times, and old Crane High is still there. And if you're ever in Crane, come by and say hi.
Hi, I'm Jack Box. This is my wife, Marlene.
Hi.
We just had our third anniversary yesterday. We live in Austin. We celebrated the opening of a new business just 3 months ago, selling modular homes. It's in Georgetown, which is about 30 miles north of Austin. We both are from very happy families. Right now we have no children. There's some to come, hopefully. We're proud parents of two puppy dogs at this time. My folks, when they left Crane and retired, moved to Brady, Texas. And both are still alive and healthy, we're proud to say. My wife, Marlene, is from Mississippi, high school there, and ended up going to LSU. When she finished LSU, she taught school in Houston for a few years and then moved to Austin. We met in 1982. Been working together ever since then. And believe it or not, we're actually together 24 hours a day and still get along just fine.
Well, he's the boss from 10 to 6, and I'm the boss from 6 to 10 in the morning.
Anything else you want to say?
No, that's about it. We had a great time.
Paula and Bob, thank you very much. We really enjoyed this. And Robinson Henderson, I'll get you for this, I swear.
I'm Sue Ann Evans Elder, and this is my husband, Wayne Elder. We've been married 18 years in December. My husband works for Compressor Components. He's the president of the corporation, and I keep a set of books at the house. Is mainly what keeps me busy. We race horses, and in fact, we have one running in Ruidoso, and we're keeping our fingers crossed right now. We have two children, Philip, 13, Angie, 12.
Hi, I'm Randall Robbins, the class president, Crane High School, 1969. Tonight I have with me Denise Sales Coslow, who you will remember lived up somewhere near Catherine Street in Crane back in the 60s. She was a twirler. In the last 20 years, she's had an exciting life. We're here tonight to ask her about all the great things that has happened to her. Denise, what's been going on? As I told you, Denise has done a lot of great things that probably I need to tell you about. For instance, she graduated from, yes.
Oh, West Texas State.
West Texas State, of which I'm also a graduate of West Texas State. Yes. Denise teaches mathematics in a high school in Central Texas. That high school is?
No, I teach junior high. Lancaster Junior High.
And it's going well.
Lancaster.
Lancaster.
Married to this woman for 4 years and nobody knew it.
Folks, don't pay attention to this weirdo behind me. Denise has been very fortunate. She has met a great guy. I visited with him today. He really fits in with the Craneites. You know, we're kind of a clannish group. I'd like for you to meet Alex Coslow.
Thank you. I can start talking. How long of a tape do we have?
I'm Denise. Thanks, Alex. By the way, I didn't get to ask you what you do for a living, if anything. Alex, tell us. How do you make your money?
I'm a pimp.
Alex is a pimp. So now you have that storyline that's going to develop where we have the math teacher with the pimp. Together, folks, they're going to create a product.
I'm an honest pimp.
My name is Dennis Young, and this is my wife, Terry Milam Young. And that's George over there making all the noise. I have a welding and machine shop in Crane, and my wife works for Atlantic Richfield. We have two children, a daughter, 16, named Denny Sue, and a son that's 2 years old named Nicholas Blaine.
Well, I'm Steve Pettit. This is my wife, Deborah. We have three kids, Bradley, Craig, and Tara. We're still living in Crane. That's about all I got to say.
I have known these three guys for about 30 years, or is it 20 years? 30 years. John Teal here lived out on the edge of Castle Gap in the boondocks, loved to spin donuts at the Crane County Airport, and John and I lived off Bisquick and baked potatoes one time for 9 months. I think that's a record. Check the Guinness book. I think it's in there.
Oh, comment.
My second fondest memory of graduation night is sleeping out by Lost Lake all night with John Teal, looking at the stars and discovering the world, figuring out what it was all about.
I'd just like to say that in the last 20 years, these guys have not matured. However, I have made it. I'm a success, a huge success, and I'd like for John to tell us why these other two guys can't do anything with their life. John?
Well, Randy, they just don't have you anymore.
Thanks, John. Jack, would you like to wrap it up?
This is a wrap.
Hi, I'm still in. This is my family, y'all. But I'm still Elaine Irvin. And we'll always, probably always will be. But hello, everybody. Love y'all. And live in Midland, if y'all want to come see me, come see me. I've got plenty of room and ambitions for myself so I can do what I want to do, as always. Love y'all. Bye.
My name's Bobby Tillman. This is my wife, Betty. We have three children, Cheryl, Kristen, Brian. We have twins that are 17 and a son that's 14. I lived in Crane all my life. Grew up there. My mom and dad taught school there. We've really enjoyed the reunion and getting to see a lot of our family and friends, and just had a real good time visiting with everybody. Thank you very much.
Just for the sake of posterity, I'd like for all of y'all to meet Miss Turkey High School 1968, Glenna Nell Cotton Robbins.
Hi, everyone. I've had a great time.
This gal is wonderful, and I love her. See you guys in 5 years.
Right here on the new grand.